trainings that Tibet Action does in terms of like the behavior have actually come a lot from a lot of the research that the Citizen Lab does. Because I think like to do behavior, we actually had to understand what the threats were. So I think like, for example, like based on the report that the Citizen Lab does, we kind of saw what were the attack vectors for Tibetans in exile, in the diaspora, and a lot of them had to do with attachments and stuff like that. So then we started kind of like thinking about how do you change that behavior, right? Can we do it through trainings? Can we do it through public awareness campaigns? Can we do it through like content creation of like community-specific content creation? So that's kind of like how we started doing all of that.
Oh, email this one. Sure.
That's the
Email job.
So we did like kind of funny videos, kind of like explaining what attachments are. Why should you like not use attachments, and like coming with taglines something like detach from attachments. That's one of something that we've been using, and it kind of resonates with Tibetans because like detach from attachments is also a very Buddhist philosophy, so resonating with the community itself, so people kind of understood that.
Wait, this le my income tax le goni kiran ji adar number ding al te ut temo do rang le ngi gi ji chim phusar.
And then kind of seeing that that actually has an impact, where I don't know like whether we can actually say it's a complete impact, but like there were a couple of other reports which actually showed the shifting tactics of the Chinese hackers, where you could actually see them like changing, instead of like attachments, they were sending phishing links, Google Drive attachments and stuff like that. So we could see those things, and but at the same time, because of the collaboration, I think one of the great things was like we could see those shifting tactics, then we had to change our training to changing different behaviors. So what are the new behaviors that people are using? How can we change that?
Delete.
In terms of thinking about like somebody who's in compromise, I think one of the things that like really happened like a year or two back was actually doing a training itself. So we were talking about like compromises and stuff like that, and then suddenly somebody's email was compromised. And thankfully, during the training, it was like there was Seth and a couple of others from the lab there. So it was basically like trying to look at how the compromise happened. Like it was basically somebody's email was compromised and how that happened through an attachment that was downloaded on computer. And like it was really interesting because that person had turned on two-step verification, but they were able to get into the computer and turn two-step verification off so they could access the email from another location. So it was kind of like, so sometimes you see stuff like that during a training, and it's really, I mean, like, it's not great that somebody's compromised, but when you see something like that in real time at a training with like other participants, it actually really makes people think, wow, there is something going on. It's just not like, oh, you can get hacked, but it's actually like you see somebody's email account being hacked. So I think that was like one of the really great examples, especially during a training. In terms of like the Tibetan community as a whole, I think like because there's been so much attacks going on for the last like decade or so, there is a really good awareness among the community that like you can be targeted and you might be targeted. So there's always that fear that like somebody might be targeted, but I think like whether that actually translates into like better practices depends a lot on like whether they're part of an institution, whether they're working for an organization, and whether they think that the data that they have is important. So trying to get people to understand what data is, I think it's also a bit of a challenge, because if you think about data in the Tibetan context, it's like everyone has data that is important in some ways, but then people usually assume that if you're working for the government or you're working for an organization, that that data is important, but not other data, not your social context and everything. So I think that's the challenge.